When Knut and I first started speaking about this very topic, Knut said the first question you need to ask internally, which now sounds very obvious, is do you actually need process development? So Knut, if you're a non-PD professional, maybe you're scientific, obviously by background, but a business professional, and you're a CEO at a emerging biopharma, how do you understand whether you actually need, forget about do you need more? Your question was very fundamental. You have to decide if you need it at all.
Right. Yeah, and it really comes down to which phase you find yourself in the product cycle, right? I mean, if you're entering a phase one trial, first of all, there is still room for process development if you want, meaning that the process you're using to make the product has not been locked. That's different when you get into a pivotal phase three trial. At that point, you have to lock the process. Any process changes you make after that are hard to implement in the sense of comparability studies and other regulatory hurdles, so to speak. So again, if you're early in the product cycle, you might consider process development at the CDMO. Certainly for a pivotal phase, you're not. Now, and then again, it depends on what resources you have and where. I can use Mustang as an example because I know it best, is we have academic partners where a lot of the process has been developed. We take that process to Mustang and look at if it's a commercially ready process or a suitable process. We make the changes that are needed. Often that's just minor changes like closing the process step that is currently open. And then if we go to a CDMO, we hand it over and don't need process development. Now, in other processes where the resources internally are not available, we might ask them for process development. But again, it depends on where you are in the life cycle of the product.